In this video, we can talk about the fetal membranes. Here, fetal membranes are of four types. They are the yolk sac, allantois, as well as the amnion and the chorion. Here you can see I have developed a simple mnemonic for the fetal membranes. You are added in a special BMR company. U means yolk sac, R means amnion, added means allantois, splanchnoflure, birds, as well as the mammals, reptiles, and one more fetal membrane, that is chorion. Here you can see the fetal membranes. Fetal membranes are developed from the tropoblast of the fertilized ovum. Develops the extra embryonic membranes or fetal membranes. They are yolk sac, meant for nutrition, allantois, chorion, and amnion. Yolk sac is meant for nutrition. Allantois will act as a functional kidney as well as excretory system. Chorion can provide protection, respiration, and placenta formation. Amnion gives protection to the growing embryo from mechanical injuries, as well as it also gives protection against the desiccation. Here you can see the different fetal membranes. The fetal membrane, which are developed from the tropoblast, here you can see the embryo is surrounded by amniotic fluid, amnion. Amnion is having a cavity called amniotic cavity. With the help of amniotic, it is a slightly alkaline solution, a salty solution. With the help of that, it can provide a watery movement to the growing embryo and gives mechanical protection against the mechanical injuries as well as from the desiccation. Whereas umbilical cord, the amniotic fluid, the embryo, as well as uterus wall. Here you can see the different functions of fetal membranes. Fetal membranes are of four types: yolk sac, allantois, amnion, and chorion. Yolk sac is meant for nutrition. Allantois will act as a functional kidney, urofunctional excretory system. It can excrete away the harmful excretory products from the embryo. Amnion is a watery fluid which is gives an artificial swimming pool to the growing baby. Chorion is the outermost fetal membrane. It is meant for the nutrition, protection, respiration, as well as the placenta formation. Here, the yolk sac and allantois is developed from the splanchnoflure. Splanchnoflure means it is made up of inner endoderm and outer mesoderm. The yolk sac is meant for nutrition and allantois is meant for excretion as well as respiration. Here you can see the different fetal membranes. The first and foremost fetal membrane is yolk sac. Yolk sac is the first fetal membrane developed during embryonic development. It is formed of splanchnoflure. Splanchnoflure means it shows inner endoderm and outer mesoderm. Its main function is nutrition. It is having connection with the gut by means of yolk stalk. The glandular walls of the yolk sac secretes digestive enzymes which convert the insoluble yolk into soluble form. It is absorbed by the yolk sac wall and it is sent to the embryo where the embryo grows. It can combine with the chorion to form chorio-vitelline placenta. The allantois is developed as a diverticulum from the hind gut of the third day of the incubation. It is formed of splanchnoflure. It is made up of anterior stalk and distal vesicle. Here you can see the cavity is filled with saline fluid. It is highly vascular structure. It performs the following functions. It is a precocious urinary bladder filled with excretory products, mainly the uric acid. Allantois, it acts as a respiratory structure because the allantoic blood vessels embedded in the chorion and acts as aids in respiration. It is an organ of nutrition. It can utilize albumin. It can combine with chorion to form chorio-vitelline placenta. Chorio-vitelline placenta. Here you can see another two fetal membranes, amnion and chorion. Amnion and chorion is developed from somatoflore. Somatoflore is made up of a mesoderm and ectoderm, inner mesoderm and outer ectoderm. In the case of amnion, it shows inner ectoderm and outer mesoderm. Amnion acts as an artificial swimming pool for the growing baby. It gives protection from the shocks and mechanical shocks and injury. It prevents from the desiccation. It acts as an artificial swimming pool for the growing baby. Next one is the chorion. Chorion is meant for nutrition, respiration, and protection. This chorion is also developed from the somatoflore. It is made up of inner mesoderm and outer ectoderm. This chorion is meant for placenta formation, combines with the yolk sac to form chorio-vitelline placenta. It combines with the allantois to form chorio-vitelline placenta. It is responsible for respiration and protection. Here, the amnion, the fluid-filled embryo, sac surrounds the embryo in reptiles, birds, and mammals. Is called amnion, which is developed from the somatoflore. Somatoflore means it is made up of inner mesoderm and the outer ectoderm. It is made up of outer ectoderm and inner mesoderm. The amnion can provide watery environment for the growing embryo. It can provide protection for the embryo from the dangers of desiccation and mechanical injuries. It can protect the embryo from external shocks. It aids in absorption of albumin. It protects the embryo from adhesion with the cell and other embryonic membranes. Here you can see these amnion. Nowadays, the pregnant woman, the amniotic fluid is extracted from the pregnant woman and it is analyzed from chromosomal abnormalities. If any chromosomal abnormality is there, the growing fetus is discarded or it may go for abortion. But this amniotic fluid is also cultured for chromosomal analysis, where X and Y chromosomes are analyzed. Thereby, the sex determination is also done with the help of amnion. Nowadays, the amniocentesis or amniotic fluid synthesis is totally banned in India. It aids in absorption of albumin. It protects the embryo from adhesion with the cells and the embryonic membranes. This is the chorion. This is the outermost cellular layer of the birds, reptiles and birds, reptiles and mammals. It is developed from the somatoflore, consisting of outer ectoderm and inner mesoderm. It is responsible for placenta formation as well as protection and respiration. Generally, there are four extra embryonic membranes are there. One is yolk sac, allantois, chorion, and amnion. Yolk sac is mainly devoted for nutrition. Allantois is meant for the precocious urinary bladder. It can store the uric acid. Whereas the chorion, it is responsible for protection, nutrition, as well as the placenta formation. Amnion will give the protection to the growing baby, as well as it gives protection against the mechanical injuries. It acts as an artificial swimming pool for the growing baby. Thank you for watching. we will give another gist also in coming future.